So I've been working on getting this video straightened out so I could start doing some live streaming and such like that. So this is going to be a test to see how the video looks and how it sounds in the end. So I thought I'd work on this guy. I have his hand here that I still want to finish off. I'm really liking this kind of smeared charcoal effect and how the arm's kind of coming out of the smoke like stuff. So I'm going to leave that. And the thing that I'm loving about this process is letting it be messy. It's okay to be messy. I think everybody is trying to get everything super clean and I think there's a lot of merit to that. But on the other side of that coin, don't think it's got to be that way. Don't think it has to be super clean to be considered art or can be considered relevant, if you will. I like having this, the messiness. To me, it frees me up to not sitting there trying to worry about where my hand is sitting and how it's sitting, but for me to just let go and do the work and let the creatures and the whatever they are appear. So anyhow, as a matter of fact, I'm adjusting a little bit of that color intensity because it looks like everything is very orangey, so I'm bringing it back down. So there we go again. So I think during this video, I think we're going to have a lot of little adjustments. But anyhow, here we go. Let's just start. You'll see, I'll look at my hand sometimes to see, yeah, I wonder what that looks like. So I'm not using any necessarily take and photo reference. I just look at my hand periodically and see how that looks, see how that works. But I'm also not looking for completely photographic realism here. I'm just searching for a representation. In this case, a representation is a hand. Yeah, so I'm going to go in and smear some of those lines that I got going. Ordered some more pencils. I love Staedtler. The one I'm using right now is a Staedtler 2mm. And I found the HB and the 2B work the best as far as keeping off glare. You know, a lot of when you're drawing in pencil, it'll have that kind of that glare, that reflective quality. And that comes from the graphite that's in the actual lead. I mean, that's lead. But Staedtler has a custom mixture that they've used for a long time where they actually put a lot of carbon in their stuff. And they have these new, they're not new, but they're Mars Black. And I haven't tried them yet. I've ordered them. I'm excited to get them. But I've used the Staedtler ones, and I find the HB, the 2B has a little bit more of a glare to it. But the HB just has, like, no glare to it at all. And so I really like the Staedtler brand as far as doing graphite pieces and not having to have them be all charcoal. I like having the combination. I love the way graphite feels on the paper versus charcoal. I watched a video and they said it had a graphite has a velvety touch, and it really does. You know, especially if you have the right paper, you're working on the right paper. It just has this amazing feel to it. I often get asked what, you know, obviously what lead, and we just talked about the stud of lead. As far as pencil holders go, it's all up to you. The only difference between pencil holders really is the weight of them. And like this one here, these are Caran d'Ache, and they're super lightweight, and they feel great. They feel great. But in the house, because I do a lot of drawing, when I sit there watching a series or a movie or something like that, I'm always drawing something. I have rotarings in there, and those are a little bit heavier than these. And I enjoy those just as much. So there's really no, there's no big deal. Get what you can get, you know what I mean? It doesn't matter if it's cheaper ones or expensive ones. It really doesn't matter. It's not going to help you draw. Yeah, and follow the shapes. Let the drawing speak to you as you're drawing. I know, boring. And my favorite tool, the eraser. The eraser does all, knows all, sees all. Once again, here you go again. So far in my experience, I haven't found an eraser, a soft eraser, that really matters, that it truly matters what brand it is. You know, I've used Generals, I've used, I've just used them all, Stedler, you name it, I've used them, and I just, it don't matter. You know, what I find matters the most is I tend to like ones that are used a little bit. The new ones are too soft. I can't get it to hold. You know, it's harder to hold a shape when you do what I'm doing here, and I'm trying to carve some pieces in here. When the eraser's brand new, it just doesn't like to hold very well. It just doesn't feel like it. Remember, if you want to do some gradation, dabbing it like I'm doing here does great. Not only does it add texture to the whole piece, but it also pulls up the graphite. And then you'll find the more graphite that gets on the tip, the less it's going to pick up here. And that's useful a lot as you're drawing, because you don't want to pick up as much. So you can, like here, see, just that little bit there didn't get much in that little area. But the subtleties are what I'm looking for. Love the subtleties. quiet. That always happens when I'm sitting here drawing. Probably why I don't do a lot of live video streams. Like I said, I'd like to do more. I really would. Brush. Just smear your charcoal and smear your graphite. Yeah, that's better. It's funny how the, depending on the paper, harder to see, you know, or the other way, it was like this way. It was really kind of hard to see. But when you get it up like that, it makes a little bit more sense, that hand there. You know, and I think I could just kind of work into this a little bit just to have some fun with it. And this is another example of, oh, papers are so different as far as how much you can actually paint on the surface. I do have a tendency to, sometimes I use a white general's charcoal to pull out my whites. I always wipe off my lead when I sharpen it. Didn't sharpen it enough. Details. I am going to start an oil painting here sometime soon. Just trying to figure exactly how to do it. You know, I used to work a lot in monotone inks. raw sienna, burnt umber, and a black. And man, I used to do a lot of pieces like that. I don't have anything anymore. I was a lot younger. But doing monochromatic pieces was something I did a lot. And then I watched Alan Williams start doing a whole bunch, and that just got me itching to do some more like that, you know. And so I think I'm going to go for it. You know, I'm going to risk the people saying I'm a copycat. But you know, what do they say? There's no greater compliment than somebody kind of doing what you're doing, or copying, if you will. I don't feel like I'm copying because I've done it for forever, and painting in sepia is not an original idea by any stretch of the imagination. But he's doing these freaking crazy great pieces, and I'm like, okay, I want to do more in that realm. Okay, well, this is a good test, a good length of video for a test, so I'm going to give it a shot. Thanks for watching. Bye.